I cannot call on your name and end up in chains. No way. No way. I cannot cry before you, God, and cry before man. No way. No way. For you are my God.
You are my God.
Hey, I'm not more.
You are my God.
But God will never let me down. Somebody say no. I cannot cry in your presence and cry before evil men. I was young, but now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begged for bread. No, hold on, hold on, hold on. Say you are, you. Remember to wave your hand like a child that wants to be carried. You are mine. I see God lifting somebody in the gallery over there. You are my. I cannot call on your name and end up in shame. No way. No way. I cannot cry before you, God, and cry before man. No way. No way. For you.
Ekeke raba santa raba ba ye kiriboko zindere boko shende. Male baba baba leke kiriboko zindara baba ba. Baraba ba leke le boko zanta raba shendere boko zunto. We worship you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration. Glory, glory, honor, power, adoration be unto your holy name. Why don't we just go ahead and begin to worship God this morning? Why not worship the Ancient of Days? Give God all the glory, give him all the honor, give him all the adoration. We worship you, Father. We bless your holy name. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the ending. You are the Prince of Peace. Oh, why not open your mouth and begin to bless the name of God this morning? He's the Ancient of Days. Magnify God, the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle, the one who seated up in heaven and still maketh his footstool, the one whose understanding is beyond our comprehension. Why not begin to bless God this morning? Why not just worship God this morning? Give God all the glory. Give him all the honor. Magnify God this morning. He is the creator that cannot be created. Give God all the glory this morning. He is the peacemaker. He is your great physician. Glorify him this morning. Give him all the glory. The unchangeable changer. He is wonderful. He is beautiful. He is marvelous. He is magnificent. He is the King of glory. The Almighty God, the All-Sufficient God, magnify him this morning. Let him know that you are praising him. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. Give him all the adoration. Glorify God this morning. Bless his holy name. He is the gracious God. He is the glorious God. The Ebenezer, the Rock of Ages, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, the ending, the reliable God. He is higher than the highest. He is better than the best. He is holier than the holiest. Magnify God this morning because he is the dependable God. Worship him this morning. Glorify him. He is the I am that I am. Magnify God this morning. He is glorious in holiness. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. The invisible God. The immortal God, the only wise God, your chief cornerstone, your justifier. Why not glorify God this morning? Why not bless his holy name this morning? Oh, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Why not let the praise of God be in your mouth this morning? Just worship him, adore him, glorify him. He is the root of Jesse. He is the root of David. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of Moses, the God of Joshua, the God of Paul, the God of Peter, the God of John. Magnify God this morning. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. He is your teacher. He is your Messiah. Bless his holy name. The soon coming King, the King of glory himself. Why not glorify him this morning? Bless his holy name. Worship him, the immortal, the omnipresent God, the omniscient God. Give him all the glory, the omnipotent God, the all-powerful God, the all-knowing God. Worship him this morning. Adore him. Glorify him. Let him hear you that you are praising him. Let him hear you that you are glorifying him. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. Because he's your Jehovah Rapha, he's your Jehovah Rohi, he's your Jehovah Nissi, he's your Jehovah El Shaddai. Magnify God this morning. Bless his holy name. Glorify him. He's your Ebenezer. Oh, glory, glory, glory be to your holy name. We worship you, Father. We worship you, the Son. We worship you, the Holy Spirit. Oh, blessed, blessed be to your holy name. Glory be to your holy name. Oh, let everything that has breath praise the Lord this morning. Everything that has breath, praise the Lord this morning. You are still breathing. Why not glorify God? You can still stand on your feet. Why not glorify God? You can still move your body. Why not glorify God? You are not in the cemetery. Why not glorify God? You are not in the mortuary. Why not glorify God? You are not in the hospital bed. Why not glorify God? Give him all the glory this morning. Glorify him this morning. Bless his holy name this morning. Worship him this morning. Adore him this morning. Oh, marebo kosondo rekeshende, ikaribo kosondo. Why not brabasende lekerebo koshende rebo? We worship you, Father. We glorify you. We lift your name high. Thank you, Father. Even as we thank you this morning for waking us up today, this is a new day. This is a new day. We worship you, Father. We thank you for the breath of life. We thank you. We thank you for waking us up this morning. Oh, many people slept yesterday. They are no more today. Our home is not like that. We are alive to see this brand new day. Glory be to your holy name. This day has never happened before. This day has never been in before. This day has never, we have never come across this day before. But today, we are in this day. We are witnessing this day, the 19th day in the month of March, 2024. It is only by your power. It is only by your grace. We worship you, Father. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We glorify you this morning. Thank you for the spirit of sleeping and waking. Blessed be to your holy name. We thank you for the grace that you have given us to be able to sleep yesterday and wake up this morning. Glory be to your holy name. We thank you, Father. We worship you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed, blessed, blessed be to your holy name. Glory be to your holy name. We worship you, Lord. We glorify you. We adore you. We give you all the glory. We thank you for protecting us all through the night. We thank you for protecting us even as we are waking up this morning. We give you all the glory for the protection that you have given us. We thank you for life. We thank you for peace that we are enjoying. We give you all the glory for all the progress that we have made. We thank you for all the success that you have given us. We worship you, Father, for all the favor that you have granted unto us. We give you all the glory for all the blessings that we are enjoying. We thank you for the past breakthroughs. We thank you for the present breakthrough. We thank you for the future breakthrough that we are going to enjoy. Blessed be to your holy name. Thank you, Jesus, for the strength that you have given us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the power that you have given us. We give you all the glory for all the ability that we are enjoying. It is only by your power. It is not by our power, neither by our strength. You said in your word, by strength shall no man prevail, but because you have been with us, because you are God with us, you are the Emmanuel that is in us. You said in your word, greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. That's why we are alive today, because you are in us, because you abide in us, because you live in us. Glory be to your holy name. We thank you, Father. We thank you for the strength in our body. We give you all the glory for the strength in our bones. We thank you, Father, Lord God, for what you have given us when you created us. Glory be to your holy name. From our head to our toes, we give you all the glory this morning. We worship you, Father. We glorify you, Lord. We thank you for the strength that you have given us this day. We give you all the glory for all the victory that you have given us on this altar of alone with God. We thank you for the power that you have endured upon this altar of alone with God. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, Father, for all the victories over diseases that we have prayed for. Thank you, Father, for victory over emotional trauma that we have prayed for in the past, and you have conquered. You have given us the victory. Glory be to your holy name. We thank you for the victory over depression. We thank you for the victory over immigration problems. We thank you for the victory over court cases. We thank you for the victory over a lack of accommodation. Blessed be to your holy name. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for helping all our family members. Thank you for helping all our marriages. We worship you, Father, for the help that you have granted upon this altar. Blessed be to your holy name. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for all the financial breakthroughs that we have enjoyed through our prayers unto you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Glory, honor, power, and adoration be unto your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Even as we begin to ask for mercy this morning, you say you will have mercy on whom you will have mercy on, and you will have compassion on whom you will have compassion on. Father, Lord, we present our body unto you this morning. We present our spirit unto you, spirit man unto you this morning. We present our soul unto you this morning. Lord God, have mercy. Let your mercy reign in our life, because it is written in the book of 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. You said if we confess our sins, you are faithful and you are just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. This morning, we stand upon your word and we know that you will wash us of every form of unrighteousness in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus upon everything that we are going to do this morning. In the name of Jesus, we plead the cleansing power in the blood of Jesus upon every of our prayers this morning. In the name of Jesus, from our head to our toe, we plead the blood of Jesus, because it is written in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 11. You said in your word, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. We stand upon your word this morning and upon the Lamb that was slain on the cross of Calvary. We pray this morning, the Lamb of God, the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, to wash us clean of every form of iniquity, to wash us clean of every form of trespasses, that we might have sinned against you, every known sin, every unknown sin. Father, Lord, have mercy. Have mercy. O thou Son of David, have mercy this morning. Let your mercy reign this morning. In the name of Jesus, let your mercy reign this morning. In the name of Jesus, total cleansing is what we ask for this morning. We present our body unto your able hand this morning. Wash us clean in the name of Jesus. Wash us clean in the name of Jesus. Every sins of commission, every sins of commission, Father, wash us clean this morning. Purge us of every form of defilement in our body system. Purge us of every form of sin in our life. In the name of Jesus, we plead the blood of Jesus, the blood that speaks better things than the blood of Abel, to wash us clean this morning. We plead the cleansing power in the blood of Jesus. We plead the cleansing power in the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus to remove every form of blockage to our effective communion with you this morning. In the name of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus have mercy. Let the blood of Jesus cleanse us of every form of iniquity. In the name of Jesus, have your way this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, have your way in our life this morning. In the name of Jesus, everything that we might have committed, either knowingly or unknowingly, let the blood of Jesus cleanse us this morning. Let the blood of Jesus cleanse us this morning. In the name of Jesus, we plead the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We are welcome to the platform of Alone with God this morning. Any part of the world where you are joining, good morning. If it's in the afternoon, good afternoon or good evening. wherever you are joining, or you might have come across this broadcast today. This is a platform of Alone with God, and we thank God for the life of our parents in the Lord, Pastor Andrew and Yemi Adeleke of Rccg, House of Praise, London, where who as the author and the people that God has used to bring about this broadcast. We pray for them this morning that they will finish strong and they will finish well in the name of Jesus. We pray that God will continue to use them mightily to propagate the gospel of his kingdom in the name of Jesus. God will continue to enlarge their cause. They will continue to plant churches all over the world. And the churches that they will plant will continue to draw people unto the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. For the benefit of those joining us for the first time, like I said, this is the platform of Alone with God, aired live between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m., Monday to Friday in the United Kingdom. This is where divine intervention is a common occurrence, the platform where we cry unto God in prayers, and God answers our prayers, the platform where God answers prayers. Praise the Lord. And for us to continue this morning, you are going to need your Bible so that we always make reference to the Word of God. We use the Word of God to pray. We stand on the Word of God on this prayer altar. And you are going to need your mouth. You are going to need your mouth to pray. We don't pray in silence on this altar. It is do it yourself, DIY. As I will be leading, I am just going to be leading in saying the prayer points. You have to pray on your own. Pray for yourself, pray for your family, pray for anyone you want to pray for. If you don't have anybody to pray for me. Praise the Lord. So you have to open your mouth to pray. And you also need your journal so that you'll be writing down revelation as God will reveal unto you this morning. Praise the Lord. So those are the three things which you need as we continue to pray. In the book of Isaiah chapter 43, Isaiah 43 verse 25 tells us, I, even I, am he that blotted out thy transgressions for my own sake, and will not remember thy sins. So, paraventure, you are just joining us for the first time, and you have not given your life unto Jesus. This is an opportunity for you to come to Jesus. He said he will not remember your sins, no matter how your sins might be, no matter how big they might be. He said he will blot it out, and he will not remember any of the sin. And that's why Jesus also told us again in the book of John, chapter 6, verse 37. John chapter 6, verse 37. Jesus said that the one that God will bring unto him, he will never reject. He said, however, those the Father has given me will come to me, and I will never reject them. He will no wise cast out. So Jesus is calling you. He said he will not reject you. And you have a role to play if you don't want Jesus to reject you. You have a role to play if you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. According to the book of Romans, chapter 10, verses 9 to 10. Romans 10, 9 to 10. The Bible tells us that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and you believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So this morning, if you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, before we continue to pray, because sin can hinder prayer. Sin will hinder prayer. And we don't want your prayer to be hindered, so that you can join us in prayer. Why not repeat this affirmation after me if you want to give your life unto Jesus? Father Lord, I thank you this morning for giving me this opportunity to accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. I thank you, Father, Lord God, for sending Jesus to come and save me. I give you all the glory, Lord. Accept my thanks in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, you say you will not reject me if I come unto you. I have decided to come to you now. Father, have mercy on me. Every form of sin I might have seen, let the precious blood of Jesus wash me clean this morning in the name of Jesus. I confess that I have been a sinner. Now I confess that Jesus Christ is my Lord and I will not sin again. Therefore, this morning, I declare that Jesus is Lord. Give me a new heart and write my name in the book of life. For in Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen. Amen. Congratulations this morning if you have just given your life unto Jesus and you are welcome to the household of God. After this broadcast, you will see some numbers. You can call the numbers on the screen after the broadcast, and our prayers with our pastors will be at the other hand to welcome you and to guide you on the journey of salvation. Congratulations once again and welcome to the household of God. Praise the Lord. So now we can continue with our prayers now that you are one of us and God has accepted you by faith, because it is by faith that we are doing this. Praise the Lord. Our theme for the year in our local parish in the Redeemed Christian Church of God, House of Praise here in the United Kingdom and Europe, is our year of rebuilding, restoring, and renewal, all things made new. And our theme for this month is restored health. And our Bible text is taken from the book of Jeremiah, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17. And I read, "For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord. Because they call thee an outcast, saying, This is Zion, whom no man seeketh after." Our prayer this morning is that as we begin to pray, God himself will visit you, because we are going to be focusing this morning on our health, either physical, emotional, mental, name it. And we are believing God that at the end of this prayer, at the end of this prayer session, this prayer broadcast, there will be no traces of symptoms of diseases, no traces of symptoms of sickness, no traces of symptoms of virus or ailment, name it. All of them are going to disappear because we are standing on the word of God. And remember, this is alone with God. Do it yourself. So you have to pray on yourself, by yourself. So as we continue, the book of Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. The Bible tells us, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became living soul." Why not lift up your voices this morning and ask God, like in the beginning, that he breathed the breath of life into your nostril, that breath of life should come into your nostril again and bring you back to life in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, like in the beginning, breathe into my nostril this morning and let me come alive again spiritually in the name of Jesus. Let me come alive. Let me come alive spiritually this morning in the name of Jesus. Spirit of intercession, come upon me mightily. Spirit of prayers, come upon me mightily in the name of Jesus. Breath of life into my spirit man. Breath of life into my spirit man this morning in the name of Jesus. Fresh baptism of the Holy Spirit, come upon me this morning. Fresh action of the Holy Spirit, come upon me this morning in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, fill me up afresh in the name of Jesus. Fresh anointing of your power is what I ask for this morning. Fresh anointing of your power is what I ask for this morning in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, bareboko sondo lekereboko shandalaba inamaleboko sondo. Fill me afresh this morning in the name of Jesus. Fill me afresh this morning in the name of Jesus. Jesus. Father, let your fire come upon me afresh this morning. Let your fire come upon me afresh with fire, with power, in the name of Jesus. Because it is written in the book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 19, you said in your word, behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents, upon scorpions, and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Therefore, this morning, I stand upon your word. Let your power come upon me. The power to tread upon serpent, the power to tread upon scorpion. Let them come upon me this morning. Let your power to tread upon serpent, to tread upon scorpion, to tread upon sickness, to tread upon ailment, to tread upon the, every form of power of the enemy. Let it come upon me this morning in the name of Jesus. Father, fill me with your healing power. Fill me with your healing power. Fill me with your deliverance power in the name of Jesus. The power to save, the power to set captives free, come upon me this morning in the name of Jesus. The power to heal all sorts of worries, the power to heal all sorts of anxiety in the name of Jesus. The power to heal all sorts of affliction in the name of Jesus. Because it is written, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God delivered them from all of them in the name of Jesus. The power to heal, let it come upon me. The power to set free from sickness, the power to set free from ailment, the power to set free from diseases, the power to set free from pain, the power to set free from emotional trauma, the power to set free from depression. Come upon me this morning. Fill me afresh this morning in the name of Jesus. I ask for your power this morning in the name of Jesus, because it is written in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verse 38. The Bible says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that was oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Because you are here with us, because it is also written, where two or three are gathered in your name, you say you are there in their midst. We know that we are more than two, we are more than three. Therefore, this morning, we stand up upon your word. Let your anointing fill this altar. Let your anointing fill me up this morning in the name of Jesus. Father, by your power, let your healing power saturate this altar of alone with God this morning in the name of Jesus. Wherever anyone is hearing, wherever anyone is listening, wherever anyone is watching, oh, let your anointing touch such person in the name of Jesus. Let your anointing go far in the name of Jesus. Saturate this altar with your power. Saturate this altar of alone with God with your grace. Saturate this altar of alone with God with your anointing. Saturate this altar of alone with God with your fresh fire in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, overshadow me with your fire. Overshadow me with your anointing. Overshadow me with your fresh unction. Overshadow me upon my head. Let your fresh unction fill me in the name of Jesus. Fresh unction of your anointing. Fill me in the name of Jesus. Fill your altar with your glory. Fill your altar with your fire. Fill your altar with your anointing. Fill your altar with your presence in the name of Jesus. Because it is written in the book of Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 17. The Bible says, but upon my Zion there shall be deliverance, there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. Oh, on this altar, we are possessing our possession this morning. And our possession is restored health, because we are praying for restored health this morning in the name of Jesus. Fill your altar of alone with God with restored health, the power to restore, the power to restore in the name of Jesus. Everyone that tunes in on this altar, receive deliverance this morning in the name of Jesus. Deliverance from sickness in the name of Jesus. Deliverance from problems in the name of Jesus. Deliverance from sickle cell diseases in the name of Jesus. Deliverance from depression in the name of Jesus. Deliverance from anxiety in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are watching, wherever you are listening, the word of God is forever settled in heaven. Marebo Kosonto, receive deliverance from affliction this morning in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are watching, receive deliverance from stroke this morning in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are watching, touching. Receive deliverance from ailment this morning in the name of Jesus. I decree unto you, you are cancer free this morning in the name of Jesus. You are affliction free this morning in the name of Jesus. You are depression free this morning in the name of Jesus. Receive it by your faith in the name of Jesus. How am I so sure? Because it is written in the book of Psalm 107 verse 20. The Bible says he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. This morning, I stand upon the word of God. You are healed in the name of Jesus. You are healed in the name of Jesus. You are healed in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Praise the Lord. You see, the Bible tells us, like I said earlier, in the book of Psalm 107, verse 20, that he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. The centurion knew this, and that's why he answered Jesus. In the book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 7, Luke, chapter 7, verse 7, when the centurion asked Jesus, don't come, I am not even worthy to come and meet you. That's why he sent people to go and meet Jesus, that his servant is sick and that Jesus should come and heal him. And he said, I am not even worthy to come and meet you. Neither are you worthy to come into my house, but you send the word, and I know that my servant will be healed. Luke chapter 7 verse 7. The centurion said, I am not even worthy to come and meet you. Just say the word where you are, and my servant will be healed. This morning, remember, it is you alone with God. You are doing it yourself. You are praying for yourself. You are praying for your family. Lift up your voices. Father, send me your word of healing in the name of Jesus. According to your word, in the book of Luke chapter 7, verse 7, the centurion said, you don't need to come. No matter where you are, the word of God will meet me. Father, this morning, let your word meet me. Let your word touch me. Wherever I am standing, let your word fill me. In the name of Jesus, let your word of healing work for me. Let your word of healing work in me. Let your word of healing work through me. In the name of Jesus, let your word of healing favor me. In the name of Jesus, let your word of healing work for my favor. In the name of Jesus, let there be no interference with your word of healing for my life. In the name of Jesus, let there be no interference for your word of healing for my family. In the name of Jesus, let there be no interference for your word of healing for my health. In the name of Jesus, let there be no interference for your word of healing for my bones in the name of Jesus. Let there be no interference for your word of healing for my kidney in the name of Jesus. Let there be no interference for your word of healing for my intestine in the name of Jesus. Send me your word. Send me your word in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The Bible continued. When we move further in that book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 10, the Bible says, and when the officer's friends returned to his house, they found the slave completely healed. The servant that Jesus sent his word to, he was completely healed by the time the centurion sent to go and meet Jesus. That means the word was even faster, he's still faster than the people that he sent. This morning, you are going to lift up your voices. Father, let my health situation be permanently under the control of your word. In the name of Jesus, let my health situation be permanently under the control of your word. In the name of Jesus, let your word take absolute control of my health issues. In the name of Jesus, remember, we are praying this morning. We are praying this morning. We are praying this morning. Pray this morning so that your health will be restored. Pray this morning so that the health of your loved one will be restored. In the name of Jesus, this morning, Father, let violate your word. Take absolute control of my health issues in the name of Jesus. Release your healing word upon my health predicament in the name of Jesus. Release your healing word upon my health problem in the name of Jesus. Let your word consume every form of sickness in my body. Let your word bring comfort to my body. Let your word bring peace to my body. Let your word bring rest to my body. Let your word bring succor to my body. Let your word come upon my body in the name of Jesus. Let my body hear the word of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. That body is coming under the authority of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. That part of the body is coming under the authority of the Holy Spirit. How am I so sure? Because it is written in the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 18. The Bible tells us, I shall take up serpent, and if I drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt me. I will lay hands on the sick, and it shall recover. I say you are recovered this morning. You are recovered this morning in the name of Jesus, because it is written that you are recovering this morning in the name of Jesus. Why not lift up your voices and begin to pray and lay your hands on that part of the body, that you need healing for. It could be your head, it could be your tummy, it could be your leg, it could be your hand. Why not lay your hands on that place, that particular place that you want healing, that you want to receive healing from? Lift up your voices and begin to render unto God this morning. My body, I render every sickness in you powerless in the name of Jesus. This part of my body, I render every sickness in you powerless in the name of Jesus. Every sickness in you, I render you powerless. My body, I decree this morning, no sickness will inhabit my body in the name of Jesus. Every deadly sickness, I render you powerless. Every toxin, I render you powerless. Every infectious disease, I render you powerless. Lose your hold on my body. Lose your hold on my body in the name of Jesus. You cancer, I refuse to be your candidate. My body refuses to accommodate any form of cancer in the name of Jesus. You kidney stone, what are you waiting for? Pack your load in the name of Jesus. My rebokosonto, what are you waiting for? You arthritis, my body rejects you in the name of Jesus. You weak bone, my body rejects you in the name of Jesus. My rebokosonto, rababashende, because it is written in the book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 19. Behold, I give you power to tread upon serpent and scorpion and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Therefore, this morning, you had disease. My body refused to accommodate you. You ulcer, my body refused to accommodate you. You blood pressure, my body refused to accommodate you. You dementia, my body refused to accommodate you. You Alzheimer, my body refused to accommodate you. You diabetes, my body refused to accommodate you. You nerve pain, my body refused to accommodate you. You cold and flu, my body refused to accommodate you. You virus, my body refused to accommodate you. You epidemic, my body refused to accommodate you. You stroke, my body refused to accommodate you. What are you waiting for in the name of Jesus? My body, I speak recovery into you. My body, I speak recovery into you. I recover from every form of sickness in the name of Jesus. I recover from every form of ailment in the name of Jesus. My body, you recover from every form of pain. My body, you recover from every form of affliction in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Remember, this is alone with God, and we are praying for restored health on this 19th day of March 2024. The Bible tells us in the book of Acts of the Apostle, chapter 28, verse 3. Acts of the Apostle, 28:3. As Paul gathered an armful of sticks and was laying them on the fire, a poisonous snake, driven out by the heat, bit him on the hand. But Paul shook off the snake into the fire and was unharmed. You are going to pray this morning and begin to lift up your voices. Father, make my body impenetrable for any sickness to feast on in the name of Jesus. Make my body impenetrable for any sickness to feast on in the name of Jesus. My body, hear ye the word of the Lord. You become impenetrable for any disease. You become impenetrable for any ailment. You become impenetrable for any pain. You become impenetrable for any stroke. You become impenetrable for any form of cancer. You become impenetrable for any form of kidney stones. You become impenetrable for any form of sickle cell disease. You become impenetrable for any form of nerve pain, from any form of cold in the name of Jesus. You become impenetrable for any form of prostate cancer in the name of Jesus. You become impenetrable for any form of arthritis in the name of Jesus. My body, hear ye the word of the Lord. As Paul shook it off, I am shaking it off this morning in the name of Jesus. Every known and unknown diseases, every known and unknown ailment, I shook you off this morning in the name of Jesus. My body becomes inaccessible for you to feast on in the name of Jesus. Every named sickness, every unnamed sickness, my body becomes unplaceable, unpassable for you in the name of Jesus. I am coming out on heart the same way Apostle Paul came out on earth in the name of Jesus. My body turns to antidote from any sickness in the name of Jesus. My body turns to antidote for any form of health issues in the name of Jesus. My thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. That body part has just been restored back to its previous condition in the name of Jesus. Check your body right now. It has just been returned back to the previous position, the way you have been created. It has turned back to it this morning. How am I so sure? Because it is written in the book of Luke, chapter 22, verses 50 to 51. Luke 22, 50 to 51. The Bible says, and one of them struck at the high priest's slave, slashing off his right hand. But Jesus said, no more of this. And he touched the man's ear and healed him. No matter that part of the body, Jesus has already touched it and it has healed. You are receiving, you are recovered in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voices and say, Father, repair whatever needs to be repaired on my body. And if it cannot be repaired, please replace it in the name of Jesus. You just replace this man's ear. Whatever cannot be repaired on my body, replace it in the name of Jesus. Any part of my body that needs repair, Father, if it cannot be repaired, please replace it in the name of Jesus. Replace it in the name of Jesus. Repair my ear. Repair my eyes. Repair my hands. Repair my legs. Repair my tummy. Repair my heart. Repair my blood vessels. Repair my bones. Repair my kidney. Repair my ovary. Repair my chest. Repair my throat. Repair my lungs. Repair my back. Repair my intestine, repair my nervous system, repair my brain, repair my medulla. Rebo koshende, malababa leke rebo. Every sickness we told in your health is releasing it now. Every sickness we told in your health is releasing it now in the name of Jesus. Is releasing it now in the name of Jesus. Am I so sure? Because it is written in the book of John, chapter 11, verses 43 to 44. John, chapter 11, 43 to 44. The Bible says, and when he does have spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face was bound about with a napkin. Jesus said unto them, loose him and let him go. I pray for you this morning. You are loose in the name of Jesus. Of every form of sickness, you are loose in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voices and begin to pray. Father, fill me with your power of resurrection of Jesus Christ and bring me back to life in the name of Jesus. Bring me back to life in the name of Jesus. The power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, let it come upon me this morning in the name of Jesus. Your power of resurrection upon my body. Your power of resurrection upon my bones. Your power of resurrection upon my kidney. Your power of resurrection resurrection upon my heart, your power of resurrection upon my blood system, your power of resurrection upon my brain, your power of resurrection upon my legs, your power of resurrection upon my spinal cord, your power of resurrection upon my nervous system, your power of resurrection upon my head, your power of resurrection upon my muscles, your power of resurrection upon my back disc, your power of resurrection upon my leg joint, your power of resurrection upon my ligaments, your power of resurrection upon my lungs, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, for in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Remember, we are praying for restoration. This is alone with God, and it is do it yourself. As you are praying for yourself, I'm also praying for myself. So lift up your voices and say, Father, as you visited the tomb of Lazarus, please visit the source of my sickness in the name of Jesus. Ah, we are praying for restored health this morning. And you visited the tomb of Lazarus, the source of the problem of Lazarus. You visited him. Father, visit the source of my health issue in the name of Jesus. Visit the origin of this ailment that I'm carrying. Visit the origin of this pain. Visit the origin of this stroke. Visit the origin of this cancer. Visit the origin of this kidney stone. Visit the origin of this heart disease. Visit the origin of this ulcer. Visit the origin of this sickle cell disease. Visit the origin of this headache. Visit the origin of this blood pressure. Visit the origin of this diabetes. Visit the origin of this nerve pain. Visit the origin of this cold and flu. Visit the origin of this virus. Visit the origin of this infection in the name of Jesus. Let me experience divine visitation in the name of Jesus. Divine visitation with visible testimony in the name of Jesus. Divine visitation with visible signs and wonders in the name of Jesus. Divine visitation with visible healing in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The Bible tells us in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 11. Romans 8:11. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. Ah, you are going to lift up your voices and say, Father, quicken my mortal body and let every dead organ bounce back to life in the name of Jesus. Quicken my mortal body according to your word in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 11. You say you will quicken my mortal body. Therefore, do according to your word. Quicken my mortal body and let every dead organ in my body bounce back to life in the name of Jesus. Every dead part of my body, receive life, receive life, receive life in the name of Jesus. Every dead part of my leg, receive life in the name of Jesus. Every dead part of my blood system, receive life in the name of Jesus. Every dead part of my body, receive life in the name of Jesus. Every dead tissue in my body, receive life. Every dead bone, receive life. Every dead cell, receive life. Every dead blood, receive life. Every dead vessel, receive life. Every dead vein, receive life. Every dead brain, receive life. Every dead legs, receive life. Every dead reproductive organ, receive life this morning in the name of Jesus. My eyes receive life. My ears receive life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The Bible tells us, let's take one more. The Bible tells us in the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 12. Matthew 11:12. The Bible says, and from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. Violence taketh it by force. Violence taketh it by force. That's why we are praying violently. That's why we are shouting. That's why we are crying unto God. Jesus himself cried with a loud voice. He said, the Bible says, he shouted, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth, and he that was there came forth. So we are crying unto God this morning. Lift up your voices. In Jesus' name, by fire and by force, I recover my stolen health from sickness. In the name of Jesus. By fire and by force, I recover my stolen health from sickness. In the name of Jesus. I recover all my good health stolen by sickness. I recover all my good health stolen by ailment. I recover all my good health stolen by diseases. I recover all my good health stolen by pain. I recover all my good health stolen by stress. I recover all my good health stolen by anxiety. I recover all my good health stolen by emotional trauma. I recover all my good health stolen by affliction. I recover all my good health stolen by Gabareboko Shende in the name of Jesus. In the Reboko Sundoleke Shende Rebo in the mighty name of Jesus. My health is restored in Jesus' name. My leg is restored in Jesus' name. My kidney is restored in Jesus' name. My heart is restored in Jesus' name. My intestine is restored in Jesus' name. My nervous system is restored in Jesus' name. My spinal cord is restored in Jesus' name. My back disc is restored in Jesus' name. My body parts is restored in the mighty name of Jesus. Every part of my body, you are restored. Hear ye the word of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are restored. My head, you are restored. My eyes, you are restored. My ears, you are restored. In the name of Jesus, every part of my body, you are restored this morning. In the name of Jesus, I receive it this morning. In the name of Jesus, my intestine is restored this morning. In the name of Jesus, every part of my body, you are restored back to the original position that I have been created in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. Amen. Let us take our offering. The Bible says we should not come to the presence of God empty. So we are going to take our offering. And the book of Psalm. Psalm 96 verse 8. Psalm 96 verse 8 tells us, give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. So the Bible tells us many times in different chapters that we should come and give an offering to God. So you have to give unto God so that the work of God can continue and God will bless you. In the name of Jesus. I'm also giving mine here. Even as we give, God will continue to bless us all. And God will multiply our accounts in the name of Jesus. Because he's the rewarder of those that diligently seek him. And you are seeking God with your offering this morning. Because your offering will be used to propagate the word of God. Praise the Lord. So let us pray for our offering. Father Lord, we thank you this morning for the great opportunity to be able to give unto your work. We pray, O Lord God, that you sanctify our offering in the name of Jesus. Accept our offering in the name of Jesus. Father Lord God, we thank you for this one that you have given us, and we thank you for accepting what we are giving back unto you. We pray, O Lord God, that our offering will be a sweet-smelling savour unto you in the name of Jesus. Because we have given today, may we never lack good thing in our life in the name of Jesus. Let money meet money in our account in the name of Jesus. Peradventure, there is any that wants to give willingly but couldn't this morning. We pray, O Lord God, that you provide for such person miraculously in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Take all the glory for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have come to the end of today's broadcast. Continue to pray and God will continue to do wonders in your life in the name of Jesus. Till we meet again tomorrow, same time from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. UK time for another wonderful time in the presence of God on Alone with God. I say, God bless you.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. Oh. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. You're slow to anger. Your name is